Okay, let us discuss the theory of the experiment E by M by Thompson's method. We have been discussing about the effect of magnetic field on the moving electrons, and in presence of magnetic field, the spot is formed at S2 on the fluorescent screen. Now, if R is the radius of that circular path or arc of a circle, the necessary centripetal force required for this circular motion is given by m v square by r, where m is the mass of the electron, r is the radius of this arc of the circle, and v is the velocity of electrons. And this force is provided by or obtained by the Lorentz force B E V. We have discussed about this. This is the magnetic force developed due to motion of the electrons under the influence of magnetic field. Now, since these two forces are same, we can write B E V is equal to mv square by r, and we get E by m is V by B r. So, our requisite is to obtain the value of E by m, charge to mass ratio of the electrons, that can be obtained by this formula V divided by B r. In other words, we can get E by m by obtaining the value of the velocity of the electrons, the strength of the magnetic field, radius of the arc of the circle. But there is one interesting aspect, or there is a problem in determining the velocity of the electrons and radius of the arc. We cannot experimentally determine the velocity of the electrons in this particular experiment. We cannot measure the radius of the arc of the circle here. Practically, it is not possible, or it is impossible, and therefore, we go for indirect method. That is why we make use of the electric field and we obtain the value of these parameters. Let us see how it goes. So, we have discussed the trajectory of the electron path in the presence of magnetic field, and the spot is formed at S2. Now, we will make use of some geometry here and try to obtain the value of R by this geometrical method. So, in this particular diagram, we go for certain geometrical aspects. So, this is the arc of the circle, and KC is R is the radius of the arc of the circle which we are going to measure, and D is the displacement of the spot when a magnetic field is applied. Now, say this angle C is theta. Suppose this angle is theta, then in the triangle KBC, this angle is theta, this angle is angle K is 90 degree. So, naturally angle B is 90 minus theta, 90 theta, 90 minus theta. So, continuing this, we consider another triangle OBB dash. Here, this angle is 90 minus theta D. So, angle B dash is 90 because this is the tangent to this circle, this is the normal, angle between the tangent and normal is always 90 degree. So, 90, this is 90 minus theta, thereby we prove that angle O is theta. Now, once again we consider the triangle OSS2. In this triangle, angle O is theta, angle S is 90 degree. So, naturally S2 is 90 minus theta. What we are going to prove is the two triangles KBC and triangle OSS2 are similar. From these two similar triangles, we can say that, say in the first triangle, tan theta is KB by R. Tan theta is KB by R. Similarly, in another similar triangle, tan theta is SS2 by OS or T by OS. So, thereby we can say that D by OS is equal to KB by R. I have already mentioned this, tan theta is D by OS, tan theta is kb by r. So d by os or kb by r. So finally we prove the value r is equal to kb into os divided by d, because that's the required parameter. We wanted to know the value of radius of the arc of the circle, which can be measured in terms of known parameters kb, os and d. So here kb is the length of the magnetic field, which can be taken equal to the length of the plate p, and q is given by the p and q, which is given by the description of the apparatus. The value of os is written obtained from the description of the apparatus. So going back to the diagram, we can obtain these values. So from measuring the length of this plate and distance from this point to the screen, we obtain the values of kb and os. So thereby we get the value of r. So we obtain the value of r. So our next task is to determine v, the velocity of the electrons, which cannot be measured by direct method. We measure it by indirect method. For that, what we do, we apply the electric field alone, or rather we apply the electric and magnetic field simultaneously. Okay, now we apply both electric and magnetic fields so that the spot is brought back to the original position. Yes. So when magnetic field is applied, the spot is shifted from S to S2, from S to S2, and now you apply electric field along with the magnetic field so that the spot is brought back from S2 to S2, which means that the magnitude of the electric field applied is equal to the magnitude of the magnetic force, but in the opposite direction. So in this case, the electric force is E into E, magnetic force is B E V. So equating them, V is equal to E by B. We require the value of V, velocity of electrons, which is obtained as the ratio between the strength of the electric field and strength of the magnetic field. And of course, E can be obtained by this formula, potential difference between the plates and distance between the plates, which can be obtained easily from the experimental setup. So finally, we arrive at the final equation E by M, the charge to mass ratio of the electrons, which is given by E into D divided by B square KB into OS. So all the parameters are known now. E is the strength of the electric field that we are using. B is the strength of the magnetic field. D is the shift of the electronic spot on the screen. And KB and OS are the parameters obtained from the geometry of the instrument or that discharge tube. So thereby we measure the charge to mass ratio of the electrons, or E by M, or specific charge of the electrons. And this method was adopted by J.J. Thomson in the year 1897, and the value obtained by him for this is 1.75 × 10⁻¹ coulomb per kg, and this is one of the outstandingly nice experiments performed by J.J. Thomson long back in 1897, exploiting the idea of electric and magnetic field, ingeniously used these techniques and precisely determined one of the very important constants in atomic physics. So that's all about E by M of electrons by Thomson's method. Thank you.